Hi guys, this is Asia here, and I made a tampon slash pencil case, and if you want to learn how to make this, it's very simple, and this is the finished product. It's nice, pretty, nice little ribbon, and yeah, keep watching if you want to know how to make this. Awesome. Hi guys, what's up? Today I'm going to be making or helping you make a tampon or pencil case. The first things you're going to need is ribbon. This is a sheer ribbon. Looks pretty. You can get these from Joann Fabrics, Michaels, any arts and crafts store. Then you are either going to use an actual tampon or pencil, or a nail filer. I use a nail filer just because I don't have a tampon with me. Next, you're going to need scissors to cut things up with. I should just really like precise scissors like these, not the big thick ones. And the main thing you're going to need is Fabri-Tac by Beacon and Adhesives. Yeah. And I believe this was about $4 to $5, and you can use this one to make three or more of these things right here. You don't need a lot of glue. So yeah, this size. And then you're going to need two fabrics. I have this colored fabric that's going to go on the outside and this white one that's going to go on the inside. And then you will also need, felt. And this is classic felt. It's Ecofile. This is not the one that has the back to it, but there are ones that have like, that are sticky in the back. I suggest you use those because they're so much easier. But yeah, these are all the products you are going to need. First, you are going to shape your felt into whatever you want. I usually just put like this much and have like this much hanging off. So that's the first thing you're going to do. You're going to cut your felt. And it's really up to you how much you want to cut it. If you only want two tampons in your case, you'll cut it smaller. But if you want more than one, you'll cut it bigger. And then you're going to take your fabric, and you're going to put it on here once you've shaped it up and stuff. Okay. Now once I've cut it like so, I'm going to get my fabric, and you are going to glue it on the opposite side. So, okay. And when you cut it around, you are going to leave a little bit of space or a little bit of fabric so it can fold inward like this. And fold inward like this. Alright. Now for this you need to remember which one or where the top is. Okay. This right here is the top. So I'm just gonna cut it like this. Just so I'll remember that that is the top. And then once you figured out what you need and stuff, or you're at the shaping of it, you are going to glue the whole felt onto the fabric. said, he's Fab Attack. And then once you're done, you're gonna use your fabric tack and smooth it. Next, you're going to fold all of these up. I suggest you start on the sides and then start from the bottom. So. Alright, so you should have a square-like box, and now you are going to get your second fabric, and you are going to cut it, going to cut it so it will show up on the top, or so it'll show a little bit on the top, but from here to here, it'll be covered. So, yeah. You're gonna do it. So you're gonna have it about right here. So the top right here can show, and also you'll have like a slot where you can just pin in and the felt will show as well. And when you do this, I suggest that you just cut it all the way through, because what you're gonna do is you're gonna shape it and it's gonna be like up like that. Here is the long and strenuous part of the process, because this will take you a very long time to do, and you sort of have to be precise and gentle and blah 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 blah. Now you can either use the same fabric that you use, so it'll be double, or like the one I'm using is white, so it'll go together. You are going to glue the sides all the way to where you want it to start, to all the way down to the bottom. So, okay. I want it to start right here. Now, it's okay that you have this extra. We're going to use it later. I don't want to start this up. I'm starting this up. Okay. Now, as you see right now, it's sticky on white. Like, see, it's like, it's sticky right here, and it's clear and stuff like that. That will go away. Yeah. Like, you see how it shows through? It's gonna go away. Now, this is, like I said, the hardest part. You're either gonna use your tampon or whatever you're gonna measure it with. With this. Now, what I do is I fold it like so, or like that, and then I go up so it'll have more room. And then I measure it. You're gonna measure like so, and then you're gonna go up. And then you're gonna find a place. I told you guys this was really hard. Okay. You're gonna go over, and then you're gonna glue a place down right here. And you're going to take it from where you started to all the way down. And you don't need a lot. Well, you're simply going to tap it on. And then you'll end up with a pocket. So, I'm going to show you again. So it's going to start right there where you glued it from. You're going to take it back. You're going to take it up. You're going to find the spot where you want it. And then gonna find the spot where you want it. And then you're gonna glue it. Video what I was trying to show you, but you are simply going to fold all that was left right here onto the back side. You're going to put a simple line, and you are going to make it sort of ruffle onto the front. This is going to fit 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 whatever you want to put in. Like, if you want to put in this, that won't work as well. If you want to put in scissors, bam, it'll fit scissors. Now next, you are going to put a ribbon in. Now, I'm deciding to use, actually I don't want that ribbon. You are going to just glue a ribbon down. So let me video it for you. You are going to get a ribbon as long as you want. Well, not as long as you want, but long enough for you to glue it down, but sure enough so it wouldn't be like exaggerated. So about, I think about this much. But like I said, it can be any size you want. Then you're gonna make sure they're even. So when you glue it, you're gonna glue it in the middle, and it's gonna be really small. You're sort of gonna make a line so it won't like pop out anywhere. So, and leave it on. And that is basically all you need to do to make your own tampon or pencil case. Now, once this dries, you should let this dry overnight without touching it. Just leave it like that. And then once your duck felt you used, you can also make a pad case like I made. I know this is cheetah and black. It doesn't match, but yeah. And for this, I use extra felt and a ribbon, one of a bigger size ribbons. Like this size ribbon for the sides right here. So if you want to learn how to make a pad case, just comment below. This is actually pretty tight. I suggest when you do these you could actually have a tampon or pad with you. But yeah. Simply fold it up, put it in here, and then you're good to go. I think these can fit about 2 if you stuff it in right. So basically that is it. Thank you for watching. Check out my blog. All the pictures are going to be up there, step by step on how I did this. And yeah. Thanks for watching. Bye bye.